Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Storm Chasing. Welcome back to Storm Chasing here on the New England Sports Nation YouTube channel and YouTube. We got Connor joining us for the first time ever.
Yeah.
So, Connor, I don't think Connor's ever been on a Storm Chasing video here on the channel. First time.
Yep.
Which is cool. And hopefully we do a lot more.
There's a car.
There's a car, yeah. But yeah, we have a line of storms to the north of here by like 50 miles, so it's really far away and it's starting to get dark out. So the reason why I'm doing it while it's so far away is because I can't really come out here in the dark, because one, that's going to be a stupid idea, and you don't know where exactly the storm is because it's dark. Wild animals and lightning, and it's just, even storm chasing in a car at dark, it is dangerous enough. So doing it outside, walking around is even worse. Yeah, so we're not going to be doing that. So that's why it's already starting to get dark out of Woodbury, as you can see. But
we should probably hurry in case.
We're going to walk south down this road here to show you guys the base of the storm, because that's what we can see. There's even... No, not to the playground. Just go down to between the first driveway and the bush. You can kind of already see it behind you. Look behind you. You can see it's getting dark over there. There's an overshooting top to the left when I show you guys, which is pretty cool. So even though it's like 50, 60, 70 miles away, you can still see the base of it, because that's how big. Wow, that moon is insane.
Yeah, I know.
Look at the moon.
Full orange moon.
Full orange moon right there. That might be reflecting off the sun over there from the storms.
Probably.
It probably is.
Is a car coming?
Yeah.
All right, hopefully it doesn't turn into the driveway. All of a sudden, I'm kind of cooked.
I don't think it will. The odds of that?
All right, no, we're good. All right. It's going into that driveway. Okay. All right, we're good. What?
My mom does not come out from the
cross. It takes like 2 minutes, but yeah, I'm going to turn the camera around, and there is the base of the storm, everybody. The base of the line of the storms. Again,
it's pretty big.
It is very far away.
It's far, but you could see it from here.
Yeah, and that's all that matters, because especially that's getting dark out, as you can see. I can't really chase it at dark, but you know what I could do is that when the storms come through, it will be well after dark when that happens. I could do a storm chasing video from inside my house, look out the window, see if I can catch some lightning for you guys. I've never done that before, but I just thought of that idea. Yeah, if the storms come over here. If not, then there's no need to.
Yeah.
But that's only if they do. So I'm going to walk a little forward here, just give you another angle here. And this is actually the first actual storm chase of storm chasing season. Like I explained in the last storm chasing video, when we storm chased at sunset a couple days ago. I said that the first two storm chasing video, just because it's so freaking humid outside, like, I'm already sweaty. I can feel it. Connor can feel it, so.
I've already been out.
And it's already getting dark.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's just a quick little storm chasing video. Just wanted to show you it. And today was the day for severe storms. Like, we were in a 1 out of 5 risk today. Where the storms are right now is a 2 out of 5 risk. So, even though we're not in the 2 out of 5, it's close enough we can see the storms. And that's why we can see them from over there. Tomorrow, we are in a general risk of thunderstorms, and a 1 out of 5 risk is very close to us as well. So I wouldn't be surprised if we get a storm chasing video tomorrow as well. And even this Sunday, it's looking at a significant severe weather day here in New England, which is actually insane because we never usually get significant severe weather. There's a dog box. But it looks like this Sunday, it is Thursday today, so 4 days from now, looks like we could have the biggest severe weather days in the entire New England in several years. That's what the models are showing right now. It could change. Hopefully, they're not overhyping it, because that would be cool to see a significant severe weather day here, because I haven't seen that in like probably like 7 years. But it wouldn't be good for like the people living around and everything like that, obviously. But it's good for storm chasing content, if you know what I mean. So, thank you guys for watching this video, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace out, everybody. Connor says, peace.